This sensor works with both plastic and glass fiber cables. It's important to understand that the color and reflectivity of the object that the sensor is looking at determines the detection range capability of the sensor. The brighter the object, the easier it'll be to detect. For example, this white object is detected here, but this dark object has a much shorter detection distance for the same detection distance setting. There's four connections via this MA connector, the supply lines, signal out, and contamination out. You can mount it via the 35mm DIN rail or side mount it via these screw holes. Be aware that there's a max ambient light spec. If there's too much light in the room, the sensor will have difficulty. The spec for this sensor is 10,000 lumens max, and full sunlight can be well over that per square foot, so you probably don't want to use these in daylight applications. Suppose we have an object that triggers a through-beam sensor and one that triggers a reflective sensor. The light received by the sensor would look like this for through-beam, where the light gets blocked when the object passes through the beam, and like this when the object reflects light back to the sensor. And when you have the sensor set up as a normally closed output, the signal goes inactive when the light is received. So for through-beam sensors, the output signal is inactive while it sees the light and goes active when the beam is broken. The reflex sensor only sees light when the object passes in front of it, so the normally closed signal drops during that time. For normally open outputs, the signal goes active when the sensor sees light, so the results are inverted. On delay delays the output relative to the light turning on, so it delays this for through beam and this for reflex. Off delay delays the output relative to the light turning off, so it delays these. Both delays can be set from 0 to 200 milliseconds in 10 millisecond increments. You just rotate this switch to the delay setting and press the plus or minus buttons. With the switch in this position, the yellow LED blinks to tell you what the current setting is. This is blinking 5 times between pauses. Each blink is 10 milliseconds, so we know this delay is 50 milliseconds. Let's change that to 100. We just press the plus button 5 more times to get another 50 milliseconds and verify that the LED blinks 10 times. It's perfect. The delay is now set for 100 milliseconds. Don't forget to switch the rotary switch back to run. If the plus LED is lit, then the output is in normally closed mode, which switches on the absence of light, or dark switching. And normally open, which switches on the presence of light, is the minus button. To switch it, just press that button and rotate the selector back to run. To select the output type, go back to the normally open, normally closed, PMP/MPN switch selection. This time hold the plus button down for 5 seconds. You'll see both buttons' LEDs blink. Press plus for PMP and minus for MPN, and press both for push-pull. And rotate the selector back to run. To manually set the switching distance, rotate the selector to this potentiometer setting. Press the plus button to increase the detection distance. Its LED will blink when you hit the max. Press minus to decrease the detection distance. Its LED will blink when you're at the min. This sensor is set for dark on, so the LED is active when there is no object. So this means we are not detecting the object, so let's increase the detection range until the LED goes off by holding down the plus button. Now I probably went a little past it, so let's hit minus until the LED comes back on, and then I'll press the plus button 1 more time to get right to the detection threshold. Now the object is detected at the correct range. Perfect. And of course, switch the selector back to run. This sensor supports 4 automatic teach modes. For normal teach, you just switch to teach mode, put the object in front of the sensor, or no object if you're doing through beam, press the plus button, the plus LED will light up, and then press the plus button again. The LED turns off. Rotate the switch back to run. The object detection range is automatically set up for you. And sure enough, the sensor detects the object at the taught distance. I should point out that you have about 40 seconds between button presses before the sensor times out. Minimal teach is the exact same thing, but use the minus button for both button presses. For dynamic teach, which learns as the objects go by, rotate to teach, press and hold the plus button until it blinks. That'll take about 5 seconds. The sensor is now recording, so have the objects move by. When done, press the plus button again and switch back to run. And sure enough, the sensor doesn't see the far object, but it does see the close one. Perfect. The two-point teach is very similar to dynamic, except you manually tell it which two objects to set the threshold between. Rotate to teach, point the sensor at object A, press the plus button. It lights up. Put object B in front of the sensor, or no object if you want to detect the conveyor or a wall, and press the minus button. It lights up. Rotate back to run. Sure enough, the sensor detects the large object, but not the small one. Perfect. External teach does the same thing, but you apply a voltage on one of the pins instead of pushing the buttons to trigger the settings, so we're not going to cover that here. When in run mode, the yellow LED indicates detection, the red LED indicates contamination, and the plus and minus buttons don't do anything. You can change the LED switching frequency between these numbers. That's really helpful if you have two sensors in close proximity. If you set them up with different switching frequencies, they'll be less likely to interfere with each other. If you switch to power save, no LEDs tells you it's switching at 10 kHz, plus LED is 7.58 kHz, minus LED is 6.1 kHz. Switch back to run. Now if you leave the switch in power save mode, the output frequency will be reduced to 5.06 kHz and the power consumption is reduced by 40%. That's done mostly by cutting the switching frequency of the sensor in half from 2 kHz down to 1 kHz. The switching frequency determines how fast a sensor will react to an object passing by. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions for Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.